everyone. I am M.Sc., Assistant Professor of English, K.S.R. College of Arts and Science for Women. Today, I am going to give a lucid and brief information about the historical novel A Tale of Two Cities, written by Charles Dickens. A tale, which means story, and two cities. It is a story between the two nations. So, first nation is England, and second nation is France. In England, the particular place is London, and in France, the particular place is Paris. And it is a historical novel. It was published in the year 1859. So, Charles Dickens, he took the source from Thomas Carlyle's The French Revolution. So, the source of A Tale of Two Cities is Thomas Carlyle's The French Revolution. It was published in the year 1837. So it was the source of A Tale of Two Cities. What is French Revolution? In France, people were divided into three groups: first estate, second estate, and third estate. First estate means it refers to clergy people, and the second estate contains all the nobles and all the monarchs, and third estate contains commoners. So most of the people in the France were belonged to third category, third estate. They suffered a lot because when compared with the other two people, that is clergy and nobles, these people received less opportunities and less privileges, and they paid much tax and they didn't get that much job. So they suffered a lot. Remaining two estate people, they led luxury life and sophisticated life. So they created a revolution in France. They need democracy from the government. That is called French Revolution. And the French Revolution started on July 14, 1789, and it ended in the year 1799. So totally 10 years. So French Revolution lasted for 10 years from 1789 to 1799. Who was the king during French Revolution? King Louis XVI. He was the king during French Revolution. At last, revolutionaries, they got freedom, they got equal rights, and they got democracy from the government. And French Revolution ended by rising Napoleon. It is a short and concise information about the French Revolution. So our famous writer and prominent writer Charles Dickens, he took some of the source from Thomas Carlyle's The French Revolution to write a historical novel, A Tale of Two Cities. And now, let me know about the author, Charles Dickens. And Charles Dickens, he is one of the prominent writer, and his novels are very famous. The cause is he created very realistic characters in his novel. His characters are very realistic and widely known by everyone and widely remembered by everyone. That is the main advantage of Charles Dickens. And his lifetime is 7th February 1812 to 9th June 1890. This is the lifetime of Charles Dickens. And he is called as 19th century Victorian sociological novelist. Please make a note, Charles Dickens, who is called a sociological novelist, Charles Dickens also comes under the category. So his novels are very famous during Victorian era. So he is called as 19th century Victorian sociological novelist. He nearly writes 50 novels. All the 50 novels are very famous, and I list out some of the novels: The Pickwick Papers, Oliver Twist, The David Copperfield, and A Tale of Two Cities. This novel was published in the year 1859, and it was preceded by, that is before, the play is Little Dorrit. What is the novel name? Little Dorrit. And it was published in the year 1855. So, A Tale of Two Cities preceded by Little Dorrit and followed by Great Expectations. What is the novel name? Great Expectations. And it was published in the year 1860. Once again, I just tell you, A Tale of Two Cities, it is a historical novel published in the year 1859. The source of the play is Thomas Corlett's The French Revolution. It published in the year 1837. You can simply remember French Revolution, people revolt against government. That is called French Revolution. So, French Revolution started on July 14 from 1789. It continued for 10 years and it ended in the year 1799 with the ruler of Napoleon, and of the king is Louis the 16th. And now, so A Tale of Two Cities preceded by Little Dorrit and followed by Great Expectation. About the author, he was born on 7th February 1812 and died on 9th June 1890. And he is simply called as 19th century Victorian sociological novelist. He is very famous in creating realistic characters in this novel. Now let me dive into the story. I am not going to explain very detailing the story of Tale of Two Cities. I am going to give a gist about the three parts of A Tale of Two Cities in a lucid manner, so you can get the summary very easily, as well as you can remember the story ever. Remember that A Tale of Two Cities contains three parts. Three parts, and the first part was started in the year 1755. A Tale of Two Cities, Charles Dickens began to write before revolution, before French Revolution, and he published the remaining two parts during and the end of French Revolution. So it has three parts. A Tale of Two Cities contains three parts. The first one is the recall. You can simply say it as recall to life. And the second part, the golden thread. And the third part is track to the storm. Track to the storm. Track to the storm. So recall to life, it was started in the year 1755. As I said, before French Revolution. And this golden thread, this second part published after the 5 years of the first part. So 1760. You can simply remember after 5 years. So when he was writing this golden thread, French Revolution started. And track to the storm, this is simply called as brutality of the French Revolution. Brutality of French Revolution. Now let me tell the characters. Totally four important characters in the historical novel A Tale of Two Cities. The first character is Doctor. Characters list. Doctor Alexander Manette. And Lucy. And third character, Charles Darnay. And fourth character, Sydney Cotton. Dr. Alexander Manette, he is the father of Lucy. So Lucy is the daughter of Dr. Alexander Manette. And Charles Darnay, he is a French immigrant, which means who left his country and settled in other country. So he left France and he settled in England, which means the London. And another character is Sydney Cotton. So you should understand one important point is Sydney Cotton and Charles Darnay both are looking very similar. Very similar. You come to understand this important point in the third part of A Tale of Two Cities. So, Dr. Alexander Manette, he was imprisoned for 18 years. He was imprisoned for 18 years in Paris. The prison name is Bastille. So, Bastille, how many years? 18 years back in Paris. Actually, the recall to life focus on Dr. Alexander Manette. After 18 years only, this part started. So when the spot started, Alexander Manette, he was released from the prison after 18 years. And one of his servant, Deforage, okay, his servant kept him in his house in a safe manner. and he forgot everything because he was in prison for 18 years and he was spending his time in making shoes most of the time. Even his fingers are he couldn't feel anything in his finger, and he forgot the entire past life. He didn't remember anything. In that way, the first part started. When the first part started, Jory and servant Lucy, they both of them went to Paris to see Dr. Alexander Manette. Lucy went to Paris and she saw Alexander Manette, and both of them united. At the time, Alexander Manette forgot everything, but he gradually recalled his past about his daughter through Lucy love. Because Lucy showered her unconditional love on Dr. Manette, that makes Dr. Manette to remember his past life. So he gradually recovers. That is the first part. You can relate this topic to Alexander Manette. Alexander Manette, he was in prison for 18 years. After 18 years, he was back to his life because of Lucy. That is the first part, recall to life. And let me say second part, the golden thread. It was started after the 5 years of the first part. So the year is 1716. It focuses on Charles Darnay. Charles Darnay, he is a French immigrant. He settled in London. He automatically fell in love with Lucy. When he fell in love with Lucy, Sidney Carton also loved Lucy. But Lucy only showed her respect to Charles Darnay. Charles Darnay, he got permission from Dr. Alexander Manette and he got married with Lucy. Both of them led a happy life. Sidney Carton, he felt sad and he worried, but he took resolution that I'd do anything for my love Lucy, which means that he is ready to sacrifice, he is ready to do anything for his lady love Lucy. But Lucy got married, and Charles Darnay and Lucy, they led a happy life. Even they have a daughter, the daughter name also Lucy. That is the golden thread. On his wedding ceremony, whose wedding ceremony? Charles Darnay's wedding ceremony. He revealed to Dr. Manette that he belongs to France, and his uncle are the reason for Dr. Alexander Manette imprisonment. But he didn't reveal to Lucy, but he revealed to his father-in-law. Their marriage ended happily and led a happy life. That is the part, golden thread. And what happened in the third part? Track to the storm. So here French Revolution started. In the end of the second part, French Revolution started. In the third part, brutality of French Revolution. Which means, Charles Darnay again went to Paris. Why? What is the reason? Why he went to Paris? Because he went to Paris to rescue his uncle servant. His uncle servant was suffered in French Revolution, in France. So he went there to rescue him. At the time, he was arrested. And he was imprisoned. Who? Charles Darnay. Immediately, Lucy and Dr. Alexander Manette went to Paris to safeguard Charles Darnay. They safeguard. They rescued him. They rescued him. But again, he was arrested and imprisoned and sentenced to death. They decided that Charles Darnay should attain death. Okay. So, you should remember, Charles Darnay arrested twice. First time Lucy and Alexander, they rescued, and second time he sentenced to death. At the time, Sidney Carton, who looks very similar, who resembles Charles Darnay, went to Paris. What is the cause? Why he went to Paris? Because in order to save Lucy's life. In the very first I told you, Sidney Carton is ready to do anything. He is ready to do anything for Lucy. So he went to Paris. And Charles Darnay, he was in prison, and Sidney Carton went there, and both of them exchanged with their clothes, and he replaced Charles Darnay place, and they took Sidney Carton and they behead him. They behead him and Sidney Carton dies. Charles Darnay, Lucy, Alexander Manette, again they travelled to England. So, what is the main theme of these three parters? Resurrection. This is the main theme of A Tale of Two Sitters. What is resurrection? Resurrection, which means coming back to the life after death. But here, not everyone coming back to the life after death. But before, Alexander Magnus, after 18 years, he back to his life because of his daughter Lucy. And here Charles Darnay came to his life because of Sidney Carton. And Sidney Carton, he dies because of Lucy, and he thinks that that is the real sacrifice. That is the real sacrifice. So such a realistic character is Sidney Carton. So among these characters, everyone remembers Sidney Carton because he proved the real love, and he is a man of words. Like he took resolution, at last he did it. That is called Sidney Carton. Is one of the famous characters in the play, in the novel, A Tale of Two Sitters. I hope you understand the brief of this novel, A Tale of Two Sitters.